Hello everyone, in this tutorial I'm going to build this landing page. This is a landing page and plus this is a responsive. It's mobile friendly, as you can see here. Okay, so also I will be providing the GitHub link of this repository, and till then, so let's start with the coding. So let's dive into coding, and first of all I'm going to develop the HTML and let it be landing page. And link the CSS file. Okay. So we will select an Google fonts. We need some fonts, so Google fonts. So I am selecting this Montserrat font, and you can include it over here. Okay, and let the body be so if you have imported the Google font, but it will not affect until and unless you will set this font template. Okay, so for the entire body we are taking as a Montserrat. So what if I did not set any font template? It would by default, whatever your system has a font, it would have reviewed that. Okay, so just importing the link will not do. You have to import, you also have to set the font template. So and now let's start with the header. This is we have to choose the logo. And where, yes, here's the logo. And we are going to style the header. So we are directly selecting this tag. Okay. Now I need a I'm going to open live server. So you can see here this header is here. Okay, that's good, but let's style this more. Even padding 1 rem and 10 rem. So this rem is equal to 1 rem is equal to 16px indirectly. Okay, it represents that. And what is this padding? There are only two values. You might be confused. Okay, so basically it is this first one represent as a top and bottom, and this is a left and right. Okay, so basically it is very similar to like this. So it's a shorthand. Okay, and whenever you are only passing a single value, then it's representing the whole four sides. Okay, so I hope this is clear to you. So because I am going to use this a lot, this shorthand, in this tutorial. And let's say what's the output. Okay, like start with the navigation links on li. So these are some texts which I have copied for saving my time. Okay, and so this is UL and LI, and suppose that we have some basic knowledge about this UL and LI, how it works. So this is how it looks right now, but we want them in a row, so we are going to use a flex. Okay, flex box. So what a flex does is it displays its elements in the row, as you can see here. Okay, and also we need to fix this, and so we are going to fix this by header. So we are targeting the UL part, and list style type, I think so, none. And you can see there is no. Okay, and margin 0. Okay, and let this also be the flex, so it would be turning into the row. And as you can see over here, and what I'm doing is align items in center and justify content space between. Okay, and so color we are going to choose is the gray. It's a little bit dark shade of gray. Yes, that's good thing. And we are going to give some padding. Let's say 10px, and yes, this looks fine. I think so. Okay, so I'm using a text transform. Uppercase. So what it will do is whatever fonts there are, means whatever the characters are in this UL, it would be into the translated into the uppercase. So as you can see over here, and let's say we can font weight, I think so we have to pick some font weight. Okay, yes, this seems fine. And okay, so what I'm representing them is they are links for now. So whenever the pointer is over here, this pointer should convert into the represent it as a link. Okay, so we can use cursor. Cursor pointer, yes. Okay, so we need this last one to be a little bit different. So I'm going to target this last child with the same syntax, header ul li last child. Okay, so this is going to target the last child, and border 2 3x solid. Okay, and this color also need to be changed. And yes, this is looking fine. So what I need is whenever this is over, so this hover represent whenever we are hovering over the okay and the text. What I needed was text decoration, underline, and let's see. Yes, this is working. Okay, this is working, but for color it should be black. Okay, for this one I am going to change the effect. So we already have targeted the last child, and we would copy the same, but this time I would select the hover. Means on hover, what we are going to do is will be decided here. So for on hover, I think so we need the background color should be black. Okay, and color should be, font color should be white. Okay, and this text and that has been done. Okay, yes, so it is working fine. So this is our header. So now coming to the banner part. So this is banner, this banner class I'm going to define some styles, like we need this padding. I need a background color to be somehow and this should do. Okay, we are going to what we need is here HR. So what I will do is let's say small HR. I'm going to make a class small HR. And its width be, let's say 150 px, and margin be 0. So due to which this HR is come to the left part. Oh, one more thing, I have to add the normalized CSS. And I am going to add it here. So what normalized CSS does is there are different browser specification for the elements. So it what does it it indirectly do is it is reset the whole elements and whole style of the browsers according to the web. So okay, now for now we need a header. h1 and I'm going to paste this text. Yes, as you can see here. So what I want my banner title, now for the banner the color should be yes. And below that there should be p tag, okay, and there should be a button over here. With the view plans, so I'm going to take this class and target the button inside that. So what it is saying is every button inside this class, okay, in short. And padding be 10 px, text transform be uppercase, and background color be transparent, and the color be white, okay, and border be 2px solid. As you can see here, so we need a image over here. So for that image, as you know, we have to display this container as a flex. Okay, so for on over this should change. There should be some effect okay, let's make this. So this is on over effect. Background, let background color be FF and color be black and cursor be pointer. Okay, this looks nice. So font size, let's say font size be 600, sorry, 600, not 6, size, it should be weight. to define the lesson. Okay. Now we are going to use the image. Okay, now what we want is our image to be this side. So we are going to use a flex on this banner. Display flex. And as you can see over here. Okay, now we need some padding over above here, and let's fix this height. Let's height would be 4rem, and height would be 600px. Okay, so height 400px should be fine. Now I want this image to be a little more, and also I want the space between them. See if I can gain space. I need to change this image. Dot banner. This would be and I photo. Okay, and side is not. Object fit. So this property would it would not let this image to be stretched. As you can see here, the image is not stretching, but what we need here is we need this to be little, so I think so I'll do it. Yes, it's looking good, but there is an extra spacing over here, so let this look okay. So the width is automatically. I think height needs to be 100px. Let's see. Let's adjust this 100px. Okay, this is somewhat looking nice. So this object fit, what it does is this contain means the whole image is contained inside this whatever height and width we have specified. So the image will not stretch or compress, means not stretch for the view itself. Okay, and we need some control right. So you can see over here there is two. So to adjust them, we can change their position to absolute. So what absolute does it? It looks for the its parent, which is the relative, related to it. It changes its. So what we need to do is, we should position relative. No, it's not this one. No, it's the main banner. And we should change their bottom also 0. Okay, no change. And as we can see here, this bottom, I need to fix this bottom. So what, as I said, absolute has absolute will behave like very different from other elements. So it have it has two it has four another property, left, right, bottom and top, which you can set. And as you can see, we need this one to be on the top. So we will be doing top 0, and yes, I guess it is somehow looking fine. I think so. I should resize it. Both the. So let the height be 200px. Let's see what. I think so. I cannot set height to the absolute. Yes, so N, but it is looking nice. Okay, now coming to the main part. So view dot main. So for main, we are going to also play with the same padding and all, and because the layout demands it. Okay, and we need so this is very on the go. So what we can do is for the main we can set margin top that it be 200px, yes. For this H1, we are need to have another font. So I'm going to use so this looks fine. So I'm importing this font. And only for H1, H2, H3, H4, H5, H6. I'm going to specify this font family. So as now you have known, just importing in the zone box, you have to also specify the font family. Okay, and this should okay, this is looking fine. And now we are going to use another tagline. I'm just using this for my saving my time. Okay, h1. Yes, as we can see here, we are different. And now comes to the there is another view. Features. Please begin. And as for now, you know this. What is this, what this syntax does? So I don't need to explain it. Because we are going to use image. Snapping process. We are going to use some tags. Let's copy this. And we need some padding. Okay. So is you know we are going to use some padding, and padding would be like say 10px. Okay. Now this looks fine. And below that we are going to add disclaimer. Okay. Also in this disclaimer section we need some kind of padding. Okay, now we need a background for the like this one. Okay, this looks fine. Yes, just a little bit change in the padding. Okay, wow, good. And change the color, font color. Okay, we need also position relative. Because we are going to use image as well here, and now what I need to do is button. Work. I px with 400 px text confirm uppercase. It's a padding the 10 px. It should be transparent, sorry. Color E white. And as you can see, okay. So, we need this to be a display flex line item center justify content space between. So the space between is both the elements, there should be some space, there will be a equal space. Okay, and this is looking nice. I think I mean to increase this okay, and I'm going to add this image. So write 0. Okay. And here is what I want is I want to hover action over it, but this would won't work. Until then is the we have to set its z index. So what z index is? Z index is basically it is laying out above element. So if I am setting 10, so it is above some elements which are normal, above the normal elements. However, so let's remove this z index and see. Yes, yeah, we can now hover because this image is over it. So whenever we position a z index, we set a z index value, so it would be on top of this image. Okay. And font weight B. Bold. Okay. This looks awesome. Yes. So now we need to design the footer part. So for the footer, let's see. Socials, image, let's do it. Social links. Image. And you can see over here so for footer I need to change this color Yes, this one is fine. Also, the pairing, we need this kind of pairing. Yes.
Okay, sorry.
And yes, so to display this in row, guess what we have to do? Yes, display flex. Grab this class socials. And yes. So on this hover, I need some action to be happen. Just see this and do this align item center. On hover. Let the cursor be pointer. Okay. And yes. Filter at a brightness is 0. Oh yes, this is 0. So what is a filter property? So basically filter property has some values, filter which can change the element, and as you can see over, this is a filter. The filter CSS property applies effect like blur element to a shift or a color shift element. So these are various effects. You can try out this and understand what is this filter effect. Okay, so yes, it makes changes, color changes, mostly visual changes to the element. Okay, okay, for now move on to, let's say, we need a HR. Let's say we add some IS 10px. So now what we are going to do is we are going to add some links. I'm going to take these all links. Okay, so I need to remove this one. So yeah, we can see our link, and yes, we definitely have to style this one. And so for that, we are going to use flex, as you know. Adding 10px. Okay, now it's there. open a start. Let's make this link. Okay, I should have made this link stuff on this one. How does it use? Okay, the let's cancel it. Well, it's not the actual link. So what we are going to do is, for now, on the board. Okay, I need some dark color here. It's not working. It should be something like this. Yes. And yes. So I'm now going to add a media query. So this page looks fine, but whenever we are trying to make it responsive, as you can see, the whole thing is not responsive. So what can I do is, whenever there is 1024 pixels, for that I need to I think about this. And yes, as you can see this header on it's flowing, it's we are adjusting it, and we have to catch all this like a banner. Yes, this banner has also yes. Okay, so we also need to fix this. This main class. Yes, as you can see, okay, this looks fine. And now there is a problem of this button. Let me fix that, but first with the footer. One argument, okay, and this also looks quite cool. Okay, and this button needs to be then set index 10. Did I add any? I need to check this banner. Okay. Now what seems to be a problem was that Z index doesn't work whenever you are not setting, but why is it you're working? So basically a Z index works with the position if we have applied the position, okay, but strange is here why it is working here and I have not applied the position over here on this button. I guess and where this is constrain it is, but I think so. I need to add position relative. It's very strange. Okay, now for the mobile view. So for the responsive, whenever the things get more and more smaller, we need to fix this out. So what I will do is create another media query. And what I need is a menu. I can't find it right now. Icon menu. So I want this to be displayed whenever the so give it the class. Let this display none, and whenever so display none just removes the element from the document, okay? And whenever it is display block, whenever it is responsive, yes, as you can see here. So what we now do are going to do is we are going to remove this also navigation. For this navigation we have to select this class. There is no class, but we can select that UL. Other UL. Okay, and we are going to change this banner also. So for that there will be going to be a mobile banner. And you can see this, but this should not be visible. So generally we are going to take it as a display null. None, okay. And whenever we are in this stage, it's a block, and for this banner, make this banner to be display none. Yes, the whole banner is out of here. Okay, now what we are going to do is copy this exactly. And you can see here, just we don't need this one. Suppose a banner. Maybe I have to make this with K. Yes. and button the npx x transform model color be now what we are going to do is we are going to add images so this should be top. Top 0. This should be something. I'm just changing the width, not setting the margin, so it would be in this. Oh, okay, I've done some mistake here. Okay. And this needs to be reflects. Okay. Now I'm just going to change the direction of the flex. This was row by default, and I'm going to make it column. And when we can see here. Same goes for that. This also has turned to oh.
I need to fix that because the image is not so proper. There was a disclaimer over here also. So basically, we need that the same, but for display should be null. Okay. And whenever the block, so we need to change this. And when this came over, so let's stop B zero. Okay. So now we are tagging this image. This button, how this buttons. Background color be transparent, the color be white, and border be oh, this HI is should be above here. Margin and this needs to be fixed. Okay, so this can be easily fixed, as you know, and this length. how j. And there is some issue on should I contain. So there is a okay, now I know this this is due to which there is this needs catch the lines center. It's okay, so now we need to this do this okay, side menu. For the side menu there is a logic and engage background color, let the background color be this one. Okay, and position fix for 0. Bottom 0, right 0, leave aside. let's say z index be okay, so we know now which should be 100%. And left do minus 100%. So it is inside here, the whole is here. So I need to attach a function over here. So I'm going to create a JavaScript file. Function click show menu. Document dot get element by ID. I need to add a ID like a site to this element on this hidden element. So the navigation menu is currently this side of the screen, means it is left, it's minus 100. So whenever I cancel this 100%, then it is, as you can see, on class name. So it is just getting this element and adding the class name. So what is should be let's say a site show. Okay, and just make this aside, so left equal to 0. Okay,
I have not yet added JavaScript. And I think we can do some transition. We need some transition effect. Transition. So what transition does is it's a kind of it's animation. So it will help. See. It will help with the. So this is a easy. Okay. I think so. I need this to be somehow faster. 0.6. Okay, this is working fine. I need to add the header in this aside. There is. Side menu and img. Okay, img. So we need logo. Close. Down and add some padding. 1 rem. Yes. So we need to display flex here. Display flex. Yes. Justify content. Space between and yes, as you can see over here. So on this cross click, we have to add on hide function. Sorry, hide menu. Okay.
and same logic, just remove the, so there will be only a site which will be defaulted hidden. And yes, let's move. Okay. And now we need to add links. And okay, we can see over here. Okay, now we need to and yes, it's looking fine. So okay, so we need to target this one. Last one. I need to fix that first. Yes. Then yes, and it's looking nice. Let's play this effect. Okay. And this is the final result. So okay, now we need to hide this. This one is appearing. I need to fix this. And this seems to be main miscom is hidden and this now why this is not working? how is this working? Okay, so actually display, I'm using display for two times. So the mistake was that I was using display two times and I didn't realize that. Funny it is. Okay, this seems to be now working fine. Okay, and yes, it is mobile responsive. So thank you guys for watching this tutorial. I hope so. If you found it useful, just like and subscribe and share between your friends.